Hi everyone, welcome back to our support question of the day series. I'm Natalie. Today's support question of the day is, how do I host and configure my own Minecraft server? First, you will need to download the Minecraft server software package. You could do so by visiting minecraft.net/en/download/server. Click minecraft_server.1.10.jar to begin downloading. By default, the file will save to your downloads folder, but it is recommended that you create a new folder on your desktop for your server. Locate the file and move it to your new folder. Ours is named Minecraft. Double-click the file to run the server. Doing this will create three new files: logs, server properties, and EULA. Open the EULA file using a text editor of your choice and change false to true. Save the file and exit the document. By saving the EULA to true, you are agreeing to Minecraft's EULA agreement. Once the server is running, you should see a window like the one currently on the screen. Now that you have started your Minecraft server, you will have to port forward port 25565 to the internal IP address of your server in your router. To do this, you will need to sign into your router. We will be using ASUS in our example. Next, locate the port forward settings. This can be found in our example by clicking WAN under Advanced Settings and then clicking Virtual Server /port forwarding. Fill in the boxes with your service name, port range, local IP, and the local port. In this case, we will be using Minecraft as our server name. Enter 25565 into the port range and local port boxes. Enter your internal IP address under local IP. Select both under protocol. Once complete, click the Add button. Next, go to portchecktool.com and make sure port 25565 is open. Please note, before running your port check tool test, make sure your server is open. Now you need to configure a way to keep no IP up to date with your changing IP address. To do this, you can download our free dynamic update client by going to www.noip.com/download and clicking the download button. We are downloading the DUC on a Mac, but Windows and Linux clients are also available. After it has finished downloading, go to your downloads folder and double-click to open the file. Read our license agreement and click Agree. Drag the NoIP logo into the Applications folder. Now find the NoIP DUC in the Applications folder and double-click to open. You will be prompted to log in. Enter your NoIP email address and password. Select the host name you want associated with this client. After you select your host and save your settings, everything is done and your host should be updated whenever your IP address changes. You need to be sure your computer and DUC are running at all times for this to work. One way to ensure your DUC is always running is to go to the Settings tab and check Automatically Start at Login. At this time, you should be able to connect to your server, and your friends should as well. All you have to do is give them your NoIP host name, for example, yourname.serveminecraft.net:25565, which is the port number you already opened, and they should be able to connect. Thanks for tuning in to today's support question of the day video. Have a question of your own? Leave it below in the comments. We may answer it in a future video. And as always, subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.